Hello and welcome to another episode of Method. Today we're gonna make a huge refactor to our game. Previously, we haven't had any way to interact with tiles in a proper way. We had grounds and tiles were not ground. But now I want to open up this game engine to be able to recognize when we hit tiles. Look at this. So what I did there, I hooked this up to just, instead of knocking that tile away, I'm just gonna emit a Koopa. I mean, obviously this is not gonna be the end game, but we do this to prepare to be able to interact with tiles. So in the next episode, we're probably gonna add so that we crash through the brick blocks. But for now, I just want to do all the modifications necessary to make this happen. So basically, yeah, I think you get it. Whenever we hit one of these blocks, we want to be able to do something custom. So we need to revisit something that we have been working on a long time ago, and that is the tile collider. Let me just walk you through this, what is going on here. So inside the level, we set up a tile collider, and the tile collider uses the same matrix, which is basically, I shouldn't say basically, the matrix is the grid. It contains all the data of all our tiles, whether we draw them or whether we collide with them. So we're going to refactor this a little bit, and especially this class. Let's take a look at this too, to see how that works. Where do we have it? Tile collider, down there. And what this does, it makes a copy of, it's called a tile matrix here, but it's really just a grid. And then for each entity, it checks if the entity is close to a tile that is ground, and then it executes some code on that ground. So where we want to hook in is here. We want to identify different things, so we don't only have ground now, we have different tiles that behave differently. So the first thing we want to do is go in here and hook this piece of code up in a way that makes us be able to write many different handlers for this. Whew. Let me just adjust my glasses and let's get going. So first of all, we could put this in a map and what do you call it, match this code to that map. Oh, sorry about that. So I'm going to do that inline this file. So I'm going to set up a tiny API to handle this. So let me see here. I'm going to set up const, whoops, raising the mic, handlers, and this is going to be an object. Then we need the handlers for ground. I'm going to say ground here. And in this, there is going to be an array. And the first item of the array is going to be handling the X direction. And the X direction happens here, the Y direction here. It's going to take, I think, this. That, actually. And cut that out. Paste that in the first function. And we're going to call function handle X. And I'm going to paste it in here. Then we have to look at it. What do we need in here? We need, obviously, the entity. Entity. And we can see that because the entity exists here. We don't need the size at right, because that's a constant from up here. But we need a match. It's going to add match here. And that means that in order to do this, we need to go down here. Or actually, to call this. We need to use the handlers variable here, and we don't check if it is ground hard-coded, but we do this. Const, let me think a little bit of this, handler, and we check the handlers if they have match.tile.type, match.tile.tile.type. and we want the first index because this is x. And that means we now have a handler. So instead of checking this, because this would be implicit here, that we check that it matched tile of type, and this will be this string ground. This goes up here, check if it is ground, and if it has index 0, means we have a handler, and then we can check if the handler exists. We can run the handler. Handler. We call it with empty and match. Let's see how that's, make sure that that works. It looks like we can still collide with things. Perfect. So let's do that for this option too. So I'm gonna cut this out. Whoops. I'm gonna paste that in as index 0, no, index 1 of this ground array. I'm gonna write function handle y. Take the entity, take the match. And there we go. Now we can use this code. Can paste that in there, but instead of using index 0, we use index 1. Then we call the handler there. So it looks like that refactor worked out. So what we have now is an API for creating handlers for tiles. So that's pretty cool, I think. And if you know me, gonna adjust my mic, you know that I love refactoring. So I'm gonna take this part here and create a module from it. Let's cut that out, and I'm gonna create a new file. And let's forget about the array for now. Gonna delete that. Make the indention better. And then we also need to import sides here. So let's go to the tile resolver. Gonna make sure we don't use sides. We don't, so I can cut that out. I'm gonna paste it in here in the top. And then I'm gonna export. I'm gonna export the name of this handler. So export const ground, and the ground is an array with the handle x and the handle y function. Let's save this file. I'm gonna save that actually in, where should it go? Tiles. Yeah, there's tiles and ground.js. Did it end up in the right place now? No, it didn't. Ew. Let me just open a containing folder. Move that into tiles, and actually let me stop the cannon there in the background, because that's gonna be driving people nuts. Okay, so we move that in here. We have ground.js, that means we need to import this from here, so add another dot. Now in the tile collator, we can say import ground from, is it, tile and ground.js, and then we can add ground here to the handlers. I'm gonna save this and make sure this works. It looks great. This is not good, because it looks like I've been running the wrong version the entire time. That can happen. But I think it still would work. So it looks like I am actually in the workbench, but whoops. What are we running here exactly? This is the right thing. I guess I have another window open somewhere. Hold on. What? Oh, I'm so confused. Where is this being served from? I don't know where this is started, but let's kill it. kill. What? Maybe it's this one then. Oh, I copied the wrong thing. Okay, now it's not responding. So I kill a server somewhere. Yarn start. Okay, good, we had an error. So handlers, match.title.type. Oh, good. The thing is, type is not always existing, but not everything is ground. So let's fix that. It was good as we found this problem out. Because we need to refactor something. And we can't do this. Gonna add a little convenience function here. I'm gonna call that handle. I'm gonna call this index. And we're gonna send in match. No. Entity and match. Then we go in like this. And we're gonna say that we don't hard code index here. Remove that. And we say that the handler is for both as x and y. So I'm gonna say handlers. And if we have handlers, we call them by the index. Like that. So now instead of this thing, we can say this don't handle. And index is one, entity, and match. We can remove this. And up here, paste this in, and we say index 0. I really hope this works now, because I don't want to redo things. Handles, this to handle, but this handle. Okay, why did I get an S there? Have an S there, remove those. Still an error, oh yeah. We have handlers is up here, and that's the right spelling. Match.title.type. Oh, I'm overwriting this here. Let's call this handle then. Handler. And if we have a handler, we run. There we go. So it's looking the same, but yeah, this is not. The code here hasn't been done to create the gooba. The goopa. Okay, great. Next step. Now we're gonna go in. Oops. Now we're gonna go in to our tiles file. No, where are we? In the 1.1.json. And here we have somewhere bricks. Bricks. And you see that the type of bricks is ground. This should be brick instead. Gonna make sure we don't have more bricks anywhere. So basically what we have a name is what is painted like, and type is what its behavior is like. So I think that maybe we want to refactor this to say instead of name it should be sprite, and this should be behavior. But we can look at it, look into that later. I don't want to do that right now. And resetting that. But we have changed this to brick, and that means that bricks should not now be transparent because they shouldn't be ground anymore, and we don't have a handler for brick. So let's go in here, and this means we should be able to jump through bricks, and we can. That's pretty good. That means that part is working. And now we want to create a handler for a brick. So I'm going into ground and save a copy of this file in the tiles folder. And let's call that brick.js. We need to export it as brick because that is the comparison. And do we need this? I think we now want to use size still. We also want to make a little bit of a difference here. So this means that if it is a brick and we're colliding from below, we want to identify that. So colliding from below with brick. Then in the tile collider, we need to import brick here. brick. And since we are writing modern JavaScript, we can actually just put this here, and that will be the exact equivalent of this, which will be the exact equivalent of that. So removing that extra property name, because property name will be inherited from the variable name here. Saving this, and let's have a trick. Let's have a go. What happened now? Nothing. Did we break? Can't file end. Oh, what? Brick.ts. Didn't we have this in ground already? Interesting. Well, yes, let's just add a dot there. Here we go. And now we should see a console log statement. Collecting from below brick. Perfect. So now we can identify when we hit our head in the brick. Now we probably have to do some debugging or inspection. What I can see here is that we only have access to the entity, because that comes in check Y. And we have access to this.tiles, which is a tile resolver. But the problem we have now here is that these tiles are only used for collision. And we want to modify both the collision grid and the, what is it called? The visual grid. So this also requires some backtracking in order for us to understand this. So let's go into the background module here. I think we had one of those layers, background. Here we create a background layer, and it draws tiles. And these tiles are put in a grid in a loader, I think. And I think we have a level loader here. And this is quite complicated right now. I mean, it's not complicated the way it outputs, but what we need to know is that we create a collision grid and we create a background grid. This is one used for painting. This is the one used for collision. And I noticed that we don't need two of these. We only need one single grid. And this will help us a lot, because if we send in the tile, which is here, we can overwrite the tile where we need to. So I understand that this is a little bit tricky to keep in mind, so I'm going to try to do this step by step. Let's go into the tile collider. And here we can see that we have all the tiles in this tile, the tile resolver. Let's, why not just take a look at that first. I'm actually gonna send this in to here, our first handler, and send it in here, tiles, and send it into the handler again. And now we can get that out in the brick function. So let's handle here that we get the tiles and log out this to see what it is. Here we go, I'm gonna knock my head into a brick, boink, undefined, not good. I have tiles coming in here, this goes out there, or what do you say, this calls the brick is called in handle, definitely tiles goes in there. Oh, we don't have this in the Y caller. Here it needs to go. Try it again, knocking your head in the brick, perfect. There's a tile resolver. It comes with a matrix. And this I think we should always call the grid, but I guess the matrix contains a grid. And here is all the tiles for collision. So undefined, ground, and somewhere here there is a brick. I'm not sure I want to find it, but somewhere here there is a brick tile. And what we want to be able to do is go into this and overwrite one of these tiles when we see fit. And now we're copying the value of the tile in here. And that's not what we want to do. We need to copy the entire, how do you say? We want to send in the full tile here instead of using this abstraction that we use now. If we look at the background layer here, no, the level loader. Oh, where is the level loader? There we go. See, we insert the tile type only, and we should be able to insert the full tile here. Let me just quiet the cannon again. So let's just do this. So So what I noticed here is that these are just copying the name or the type. So we can actually just send in the full tile and have access to it, I think. So there we go. And I think this shouldn't alter the way the code works. Saving this file, going here. And then we knock it there, and let's see what we have now. Blow with the brick. Let's instead of logging out the tile collider, I'm actually gonna remove that thing, because that's not what we're gonna need here, I think. So let's remove that for now, and we're gonna log out the match in brick.js. Remove that, log out the match. Try this again. There we go, maybe we should stop this, because it's a little bit annoying. How can I stop it? There we go. So let's look in the console now. Now we get down the full tile, or the actual match. So it has the name, has the type, and the ranges. But this is not exactly enough, and it needs to get out the whole grid that we read from. And what I also notice here now is that we are actually have a lot of duplicate code that we don't need anymore. If we go into the level, we have create collision grid, and we have to create background grid, and these are, I think, exactly the same, except for the name. You can see if I select this, and I say find the next match, it finds this. So we don't need two of these. So let's remove collision grid, and rename it to create grid. And then we replace this use in the occurrences here. So create background grid will now become create grid. Create collision grid will also become create grid. And let's make sure we didn't destroy anything. Oops, close the file. But it looks like it was saved. Sweet. Saving this and making sure it didn't break. Let's play it. So it looks like we definitely don't need two of those. It's hard to say why we created two of them in the beginning, but that's just how codes go sometimes. Sometimes it's better to decouple early and merge late, because you never know how things are gonna derive. But now we're merging these two because we want to use them on another way. So back in the code again, and it looks like we're doing some a little bit of optimization here. We have accepted that we have many backgrounds, but we're merging the setup, the tile collisions, or the collision tiles. And I don't think we need to do that, because I think we need collisions on different layers as well. And I think that could be very useful. So what I want to do, I want to refactor the collision to accept many layers, just like backgrounds are doing. Sorry about that. So the first thing I want to do is, I say that a lot, the first thing I want to do, well, we are just accepting one collision grid here. So let's refactor it in a way so that we can use many grids. So I'm going to implement or write the implementation first. Instead of saying level.setCollisionGrid, I want to accept many. I want to be able to say this.addGrid. No. This, no, level dot, what will be good? What was it called again? Let's go into the level class. Forgot myself a little bit. Then we have tile collider here. And we want many of those, right? Now we still can get away with only one. But this is going to be up here. And it doesn't take one grid, because we want to be able to add grids. But we don't need this, I think. Because we can talk directly to this one. So let's go into the tile collider. And here I want to be able to, instead of saying this tiles, let's say this.resolvers is an array. And then we say add grid, and we call this the tile matrix, just like we have up here. And what this does is create an instance of the time resolver for new grid here. So this.resolvers.push, and we push a new tile resolver that uses that grid, or that tile matrix. Means we now can remove the constructor here. No, we can't actually, we need to still set up the resolvers array in here. So move that. And we have this.resolvers here. But now we need to iterate of all the resolvers. And that means that this is gonna be called resolver. And I'm gonna call this resolver 2. That means we need to iterate over it. So for const resolver of this.resolvers. Same thing here. Wow, I literally just forgot where the semicolon was. That was interesting. So now we have added support for manual resolvers here. So let's insert use that support in our level loader. We have a collision grid here, between level dot tile collider dot res dot add grid, like that. We're still merging the grid here, but I think this should work as expected. Nope. Tile size of undefined. Let's see what we forgot to do. We have a tile resolver here. Oh, these are where we draw the tiles. Interesting. This is a debug layer. So we need to fix that first too. Let's screen. What is it called? Debug? No. Where was this exactly? In collision.js. Collision. And we have to create tile candidate layer. Have to remember a little bit what this is. Where's this called? There. Okay, so we have many tile colliders. But this uses the resolver here. So we can just, instead of finding this, send it in there. We can remove that. And now we can say, for all the resolvers, we can do this. So I realize that this is gonna be a little bit tricky to follow. Not sure how I'm gonna do this. But we can say that level.tileCollider.resolvers.map. And here we have all the resolvers. And since this function now takes a resolver, we can just remove this part here. And this will be called for all the resolvers in here. So it means we have many drawing things here. Drawing things, or many functions that draw here. And if we just iterate over them, this should work. So we say draw tile candidates dot for each, and we get out the draw function here. We can just call that. And let's see if this works. Wow. It seems it worked. We still only have one tile resolver that we use because we merged them. But this will allow us to demerge them. So let's go into the setup collision here. And we shouldn't merge them. So we don't need to use reduce. So I'm gonna say for each here instead. And we shouldn't have merged tiles. And actually, let's just copy this. Reset this function here. Or actually, we don't even need setup collision. We can just do here because we're using the same grid. We just say this, call this grid here. Send in the grid there. And then we run this in the end. There we go. And now we can remove setup collision. Wow. That might actually work. It's gonna not run setup collision down here too. Okay, we had an error, good, because collision grid is not defined in here. Ah, yeah, we only call it grid there. Boom! So the game works the same way, but we have access to the full tile, everything in it. And we have also access to the same grid that we draw on. So let's see if we can delete a tile from the grid and see what happens. And let's gonna make that quiet. Then we go in here. And we have to go into the tile collider. And here we send in the matches. And what should we do here? I'm a little bit, need to think a little bit about this. We need access to the grid that goes in so that we can alter it. What can we do? Let's look at the game again. I want to see here. What do we get out when we collide? Boink. Get a tile and we get this position, the global position in the game. But we want the index as well so we can refer back to it. So let's go into the tile resolver. And that is actually here. And we have the index here. So let's send out index 1 and index y with the match. Let's see how that changes. Doink. Index x and index y. So that means that that tile we collided with, this on index 27 on x and 9 from the top. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Something like that. Now, if we can go in to this grid and delete it, it should be deleted when we paint. So that means we need to give access to the resolver. Yeah, and what does this resolver do? It has the matrix here. So that means we can access the grid on the tile resolver's matrix. And we can get them by index, we can get them by position. Interesting. So, let's send in the resolver. Let's do that here too. Means we get the resolver out here. Send it in there. And in our brick function, we will get the resolver out here. So when we colliding from below, we can say const grid equals resolver.matrix. And if grid, and what do we have? Match.index x. Yeah. So this, let's just see what the grid is here before we become too confused. That's a grid. And that's nice. Some of them empty. That's exactly what we want. So what I want to be able to do now, I want to be able to say grid.delete. And I want to send in match.indexx and match.indexy. So this should delete the brick layer from that resolver that we matched with. So that means we need to go in to the matrix class, which is here in math. That means it's here. And add a delete. Sorry, I forget to turn off the camera all the time. We add a delete method, delete x and y. and it's gonna be pretty much what we have here. Whoops, copy this, and we find the collision, the column. If we find the column, we say we delete from the column. We don't need to return anything here. So I think this should delete that index from this when it finds them. This is gonna be interesting. It worked! Super great! Okay, so now we know how to modify tiles based on what's going on in the game. So this is opening up a ton of interesting things. Even if we don't gonna do the final thing right now, I don't think we can do the brick explosion. But let's do something else to make sure that we can interact with tiles. So let's see. The tile collider is called from the physics trait. Physics. So what we can do here is we can send in the level, so we can add things to the level when we're colliding, and we just send in the entire game context. I'm gonna extract this to another variable like this, const delta time equals game context, and that means that we take the game context out here, and we send in the game context, and we send in the level. That means we can receive both the game context and the level in the tile collider. So we go into the tile collider, that means up here we get game context and we get the level. Same goes for check y, boom. And let's pass these in. I know there's a lot of arguments up here. We probably need to refactor this to some kind of unified object, but for now, just to make sure this works, we're just gonna paste this in into the function parameters. So we have it here, game context level. We need to send it in here to the handler. Actually, I come up with a thing I want to fix here. Maybe that's not easier. Now let's not fix that right now. This will do fine. It's very lit, very few lines of code here that's affected by this. I think it should be fine. But that means we should have access to the game context and the level in the brick collision now. So let's double check that that is the case. Paste that in. Is entity match game context level? Was that the thing we had? Entity match, now we had resolver there. That's right. Let's go to brick. Resolver game context level. So this is why you really want to just have one argument, because it's so hard to keep track of this long list and remember what order they come in. Yeah, we probably should refactor that before we leave that episode. Yeah, that's my promise. Let's see here, we're resolver game context and level. We're already doing that. But now let's create something at this place. So game context only contain, let's see, in main.js. It's just audio context and a delta time. But what I'm gonna add here is the entity factory. So this means that we can create entities from the entity factory whenever we want using the game context. So I'm saving this. That means that we should have access to the entity factory in a brick handler. So let's log out the game context and let's collide with the brick. Whoops, where's the game? There. Boink, there we go. What do we have here? We have audio context, we have entity factory, and the entity factory can create all our entities, and also the delta time. So this means we should be able to create whatever we want here when we hit the block. So let's create an entity. We delete the brick, then we say const Goomba equals game context of entity factory dot Goomba. and boom bus velocity dot set should be set it to 100, no, 50 and minus 400, so we're gonna fly up there. And goomba.position dot copy, and we should copy Mario's position, I think. Or maybe we should copy the match. Not sure here. Yeah, let's copy the match dot xy1, I think, which is the top. And then, and this means that we shouldn't copy it actually, we should set it. And then we have match dot, actually this can be the entity dot position dot y. Oh wait, this should be x, so it's a vertical position, I mean horizontal. And let's emit it from the top of the block. Then we need a level, and we need to say entities dot add, and let's add a Goomba there. Okay, it's worth a chance. And there we go. Now we can emit Goombas. So I think you can see where this would go with mushrooms and stuff. Wow. Oh, that's funny. When the Goomba hit the brick, it also emitted it. So it's not only checking the player. We should, that was quite funny, but it means that we need to check the player here, basically. So what I want to say is if entity.player, we do this. Otherwise, we just obstruct. Of course, you should only be able to destroy the brick blocks as Big Mario, but we don't have Big Mario yet, so we need to do that later. Excellent. Now let's go back to do that refactor I was talking about, because what we have here is way too many arguments, in my opinion. But what we could do is create a derivative context. So we have a game context here, but that all of these could belong in some kind of tile collision context, for example. I want to go into the tile collider and see what we can do here. I think we should be able to just cram them together in here to say const collision context. And I know this is tile collision context, just to be extra. Tile collision context. And all of these could take the entity. We just wrap all of them in here. One big bunch. So this way we don't have to worry about the order of things. And then we send in this context into the handler instead. So I know that for now, maybe this doesn't look like that much of an improvement, but the big thing here is that we only have one place in our implementation, and then one that does this tricky thing. But in the API, when we use the API, for example here in the brick, we can say this instead. And we don't have to take care of the order of things. So just import these here, and we import them here as well. And since this is not using the level, we can just raise the things it doesn't need. There we go. Think it uses a resolver, use it the game context, use it the level, so you need to keep them. But in our ground, we don't really have to care about the other things that we don't need. We can just put object masks or object literals around this. Let's see if that worked for us. Cannot. Let's go into ground. What did we do wrong? What? It didn't work. I guess I need to start the debugger here. See what it did wrong. Entity is undefined. Handle Y. Let's walk up the call stack. Oh, this hasn't saved. It's not really my problem, is it? Woohoo! Woohoo! Okay. Pretty sweet. There we go.